outside the shoulders and the bars loose in your fingertips. So the way you get the bar overhead, if you want a straight bar path, is you pull your head out of the way. Press the bar straight up, extend, bring the bar back down, put the chin back over the bar. So we're gonna do five slow. Key things on this is keep the elbows in front. We also want to be driving the ribs down towards the floor, not extending, because when the ribs come up, we lose our low back, and that's really tight on your back in that sit position. That puts your shoulder in a bad position too. So just like we were doing the power movements the other day, we want pelvis neutral, ribs down. So for me, I always think about driving my ribs to the floor as I'm pressing the bar up overhead. Bring the elbows just slightly in front. Pull the head all the way, press. Extend fully up overhead. So make sure you're like right on top of the forehead there. And then bring it back. And get your elbows back from the bar as you come down. So if I hold the bar here, drive the bar up in the air. So we talked all about hip power, you guys were here on Tuesday. This is the hip power that's driving the bar up in the air. So it's just a quick dip. I tell people it's like sitting on a pogo stick. You want your shoulder, there not to be any hip flexion. It should be knee flexion, pop the hip, bar goes overhead. The momentum of your hips is what drives the bar, not your arm. So it's pop, press up. It's quick. Boom, up. So same thing again when I walk around. It should not look like this and press it up. Everything should stay in alignment here with the ribs down, and you're just sitting straight up and down. Your knee bend should only be like an inch or two to pop the bar up in the air overhead. So really focus on quick hips, not let the bar come out front. There you go. Try to lift a little more ahead. There you go. So the setup's the same, everything's the same. Dip, but now you drop in a squat as you punch the bar up overhead. This is the one where coordination comes in a little bit. So as your arms punch out overhead, your feet slam against the floor at the same time. So we're not catching it in extension now. We're extending, but as we're extending, we're pushing ourselves underneath the bar to give ourselves more chance to get underneath it. Technically, the hardest lift, the lift you can't lift the most should be the press. That should be your least number, strict press. Then push press is second. Technically, push jerk should be your heaviest lift because you're pressing it and you're dropping under it to give yourself more of a chance to press it overhead. So this is the most difficult one, but should be the one that you lift the most technically when you get into the lifting one.
Backwards.
So the bar shouldn't raise up when you're dropping under it. The bar should really stay
there,
and then you're pushing underneath.
Oh.
So you're not going to squat really low, but the bar shouldn't, you shouldn't jump with the bar, I guess is what I'm saying. You are dropping underneath. So it's going to go up a little bit, but it shouldn't be here.
After the fact.
Yes. It should be dip, drop, instead of pressing it up. There should be more of you dropping under it than it pressing up, I guess. So it's a quick boom. Press yourself up. Yes. There you go. Good job. Nice. All right, so you're done with those. I'll take that. Now we're going to work through these three movements with the barbell. So we can grab the barbell, try to partner up. My mom's so crude. Come as far back. We'll start out with just the bar. What you're going to do is superset. So you're going to do three. So you're going to do three push jerks like we just ended with. Two, three. Then you're going to do two push press. And you bring the barbell back down and you have one strict press.